Origami Canada. Today's video is dedicated to the Richmond Hills Canada Day celebration. And in this series, I'll be showing two Canadian themed models, one of which is the maple leaf. And let's get started. So we need one sheet of square sheet of paper like this. And as you can see, I have the white side up. So let's get started. We're going to fold the piece of paper in half like this. Make sure you line it up precisely. Sharpen the crease with your nails. You're going to take one edge and fold it to the bottom like this. Use your nails to sharpen the crease again. You're going to flip to the back and do what we just did on the other side. And after this step, we're going to open up the pocket on the bottom and flatten it into a square. So the bottom would look like this with an open end and the top like this with a closed end. This is what we call a square base. After this, we're going to line this edge. Keeping the open end towards yourself, we're going to fold this edge towards the middle line, as you can see here. Same thing on this side. Again, sharpen the crease with your nails like this. We're going to open it back, flip to the other side, and do the same thing. Sharpen it with your nails. And now on these two points, as you can see, we're going to connect them with a horizontal line that's going from left to right like this. We're going to sharpen the crease here. We're going to flip to the back and apply the same folding technique on the same line. So we're folding it this way and the other way, just to help with our folds for our next step. And after you have this, you should be able to see three lines here, a triangle. So we're going to utilize this line right now. We're going to open up a flap from the bottom, fold it on that line, and then bring the sides over towards the middle, like this. And we're going to do the same thing on the back. So fold it up and then bring the two sides towards the middle. Make sure you're following all the creases that you just made so that your folds are accurate. Okay, so the model will look like this now, a rhombus shape. We're going to fold a top flap down like this. And we're going to flip the model to the back like this. And you see that you can have two little legs that move up and down like this. We're going to fold the legs up. We're going to keep them up. We're going to align the middle part of these legs towards the horizontal line here, like this. And the same thing on this side. Use your nails to flatten the model. So the model should look like this. And what we're going to do is reach into the layer like here. I'm going to flatten this part. And you can see how this forms a leaf. And I'll show you on this side again. So fold it like this, and we're going to put our finger here and then just flatten this part. And if you use a two-colored sheet of paper, like I did, you'll kind of see the vein in the middle of the leaf, and even the middle one. And so at this point, you can see the top of the maple leaf is pretty much done. Going to work on the back now. or the stem. We're going to flip to the back and fold this part up, which also creates these two little small parts that you see on a maple leaf. We're going to fold this part down around this much, as you can see. Depends on how long you want the stem to be. If you don't have a good idea, just copy what I did around that much. And we're going to bring this edge basically towards the middle, but you can bring it over the middle as well. So the whole point here is to make the stem skinnier. So we're gonna fold it like that and then flatten out this triangle here. The same thing on this side, bring it over and flatten out this triangle. And to make the stem even skinnier, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the stem here, we're gonna fold it in half kind of backwards like this. And then squeezing it till the tip will kind of form you this triangle here. We're just gonna bring this up and you can see the stem can move left and right like this, even skinnier than before. And we're just gonna pull it back down like this and then bending the stem, curling it, making it look more realistic. And after this step, you're just going to bend the whole leaf kind of backwards to make the whole leaf look more realistic. And there you go, a maple leaf. Hope you guys like this model. Thank you for watching.